Hey everybody, Ham Radio Now, episode 154, launching the Kickstarter to fund Ham Radio Now video at the 2014 ARRL and TAPR Digital Communications Conference. And I can't wait to see what the title is, shortened that down into, will be. It's not sitting in front of me right now, but I got to do it in post-production. I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ. Yes, it's time to launch the Kickstarter to see if we can scratch up the money to bring all of this wonderful television equipment out to Austin the way we did to Seattle last year to shoot the whole digital communications conference. Looking forward to being able to do that. Got to come up with the money for it. I've got the Kickstarter entry all ready to go. I just have to make the video, so I will embed that in this program and then come back on the other end, and I got a couple more things to do. Should be short. Yeah, right. Should be short. Famous last words. They recommend, speaking of short, they recommend that I keep the Kickstarter video short. Let me see what I did last year. This is last year's Kickstarter page. Ham Radio Now, our Kickstarter campaign. Oh, dear. It was 8 minutes and 52 seconds. Not what they recommend. It worked, but not what they recommend. And I see that I was over in the editing side, so I guess I hadn't put together the set at that point last year. All right, so they recommend 3 to 4 minutes. I wrote a script. The script timed out to, guess what, about 8.5 minutes. I took a hatchet to it. I hacked it down, and I think I've got it down to 4 minutes. Let's see what we've got. Hey, everybody. This is a Kickstarter project to shoot video of the entire ARRL and TAPR 2014 Digital Communications Conference coming up in September in Austin, Texas, and stick it on the web. I'm Gary Pierce. Ham Radio call sign is KN4AQ. I'm the producer, editor, and host of the Ham Radio Now series of video programs. The financial goal for the Kickstarter is $8,000. The deadline is midnight, July 31st. I think that's on a Thursday. We've pretty much done this before. This is sort of a rerun. We had a successful Kickstarter last year. We went out to Seattle, Washington, shot the entire conference, got it up on the web. So we know what we're doing. This has all been done before. Since it is a rerun, many of you watching this already know what it's all about and have decided to fund it already. So you can head over to the backer button and take care of that and just move on. I have tweaked the rewards a little bit, pretty much self-explanatory. But I will explain what that's all about and what the video's about in the conference in the rest of this introductory video. So bye-bye to you folks, and we'll see you in Austin, I hope. So for those of you that are not quite so familiar with it, let's take a look at the TAPR website. The DCC is a 2.5-day technical conference for ham radio enthusiasts, those particularly interested in the digital communications aspect of amateur radio. They have 2 days of presentations. Each one is about 40 minutes long, covering some aspect of that digital stuff in ham radio. There are some introductory sessions. We won't be covering those on video. And on Saturday night, there's a banquet talk with a sort of a keynote speaker. We will shoot that. And on Sunday is the Sunday seminar, what they call the deep dive. It's a 4-hour talk on one subject. Now, the Kickstarter is to fund me heading out there to make videos of all the talks, putting them on the web as part of the Ham Radio Now series. It does not fund the DCC itself, totally separate. That is paid for by the people who attend their admittance fee. The video, of course, does have the blessing of TAPR and all the presenters who are giving their programs. They're letting me use their content. Last year was the first time that I tried a Kickstarter to fund it. It was quite successful. Since it was all the way out in Seattle, I asked for a little bit more money. This year, I'm cutting it back a little bit. And the video series itself was also successful, pretty much thanks to you guys.
All right. Good morning, everybody. My name's Steve Bible, N7HPR. Welcome. And we're glad to have you here. It looks like we still got a couple of chairs. There's still some folks checking.
So as I said, for this year, I'm going to tweak the rewards just a little bit. I'm going to give something to everybody, the $10 backers and everybody up. And that's going to be 30 days of exclusive viewing, Last year, I just put all the videos right on the web, and everybody could see them as soon as I put them up. And they come out one at a time, a few days apart. It takes a little over a month to get everything up there. This time, I'll put them up on a private YouTube channel, give you the URL, and you'll have about 30 days to see it before it becomes totally public. I know that a URL on a private YouTube channel is not the most secure thing in the world, but that's as far as we're going to go with this kind of a gimmick. For the $25 and $50 backers, I will send you a download of some of the programs. What you see on YouTube is pretty good. It's in 720p. But the video that I send them gets additional compression and stuff. So I'll send you the video that I put up on YouTube, and you'll have a somewhat better version. I know that most of you know how to download something from YouTube. YouTube says no, and their systems are not designed for you to download. But that's easy to get around. But here, I'll send you the real video, and you'll be able to download it. For those of you that contribute $25, you'll get two of them. Pick two, any two. And for those of you that contribute $50, I'll send you six. The $100 and $150 backers will get a USB drive with programs on them. So you don't even have to download anything, because it's going to be a bunch. And these are nearly gigabyte files. It takes a long time to download. $100 will get you eight of the talks on a USB drive. And $150 will get you everything, every talk on a USB drive. Now, there's something new that I'm going to try, and this is a $500 backer level. I'll call it a corporate underwriter level 2, and it's for small companies that want to support the project. What you'll get is your logo on every web page that I put up, and there's about one web page per program. So you'll be on every one of those indicating that you support the project. You'll also get about a 10-second blurb toward the top of each program with me talking about your product or service, an on-screen graphic of some kind, some logo that you supply, or maybe you look at your web page, and that will be in every program. And I'm offering just six of these reward options. So hopefully they'll kind of go fast. We'll see. If you know anybody at any of the smaller ham radio or ham radio-oriented companies that might be interested in this, let them know about it, or let me know who they are, and we'll contact them, and we'll talk about it. And finally, the same thing we did last year, the $2,000 reward level, that's a level 1 for corporate underwriters. There can be three of these available, just like last year. You'll be recognized on the webpage, a little bit bigger icon and logo, and you'll get that same sort of a 10-second announcement in every one of the programs. And I didn't do such a great job of this last year. I kind of rambled on too long about everybody. I'm going to try to tighten that up. And then in one out of three, about every third program, you'll get a longer presentation. Once again, it's still going to be me talking about your stuff with graphics or video that you supply. And that I'm going to try to make about a minute. So each program will have about 2.5 minutes worth of underwriting announcement. And then we get on into the program. Okay, the clock is ticking onto that July 31st deadline. This is one of those tell everybody you know sort of things, or at least tell everybody you know who you think might care. Don't be a pest. Come to think of it, for this project, yeah, go ahead, be kind of a pest. Thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting the project. I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ73 for Ham Radio Now, over and out. Okay, and we move on. That'll go on the Kickstarter. There are a couple things I didn't like about what I did last year. The first one is that I didn't like how long it took me to put the programs online. Didn't even really get started until kind of deep in November, and they started trickling out in December and took until, I think, just sometime into February to get everything done. I am going to try to get things online starting in late September. The conference itself is early September. Going to try to have the first ones starting to come out in late September. And once again, for 30 days, exclusively, more or less, to the folks that have made a contribution. And as I mentioned a moment ago, I didn't like the way I did the corporate underwriting. I didn't keep tight control of that. The underwriters, Flex Radio, TAPR, Ellicraft, didn't ask me to go on at that kind of length. They agreed to what I had initially said, which would be about a minute. I just didn't keep it under control. It was my fault. So I'm going to try harder this time to keep it under control. Most of you figured out that this was going to be the same stuff at the beginning of each program, and you knew where to do the fast forward thing. And you knew who was sponsoring and underwriting the programs. And I think many of you expressed your appreciation. So that's all good. But I'll try to still keep it more under control. All right, some other stuff. Some emails from contributors. Lee, KB4FYE from Arlington, Texas, became a monthly contributor. And I thanked him for that. And he sent this reply. I was at HamCom last Friday in Plano, Texas. I think I've got... Okay, well, there's Lee and his nice station. No picture of Lee, though. And there's HamCom. Always wanted to get out to do HamCom. And if things get successful enough with Ham Radio Now, they are really picking up. The contribution level has wicked up tremendously. I don't know if it's going to keep going that way, but it's pretty darn good right now. It's still not, you know, paying me to live, but it's getting better and better. So, all right. So Lee says he was at HamCom last Friday in Plano. Got there when it opened. My first goal was to pay homage to the Elecraft booth. However, I was diverted. The very first booth I saw was the CQ magazine booth with Rich Moseson standing there. I couldn't resist. I went over there with a sly smile, pointed to my Ham Radio Now t-shirt, so he was wearing the t-shirt, and said, I've seen you before. You can run, but you can't hide. We had a good laugh, and I signed up for 2 years. Gary, I really enjoy your work, even the stuff I'm not particularly interested in. You make fun to watch. I feel the monthly contribution is a worthy investment for continued education and, yes, entertainment. Catches it all. 73 Lee, KF4YBE. So thank you very much, Lee. Again, I swapped email with Lee a little bit, but that's a great story. Okay, next, Mike, K1EG, Glasgow, Kentucky, tossed me a note, said that he really loved show 152, the Friday Night BS, that I did with Bill Pasternak, WA6ITF from Newsline. That was an experiment, and no one's told me they hated it, and Mike liked it. Please do more of them. I'm retired, don't have much to ascend, but I needed to donate again. So, see, he did that. And finally, another Mike, KN8Z, made a contribution, and he sent me a link in the little note. And no one's ever done that before. The link was to this. It's their club newsletter, the Waveguide from the Lapeer County Amateur Radio Association. They are in Michigan someplace. And he said in particular, look over at page 3. So we'll look at page 3. And here is what he was pointing me to. It's the site of the month. I won't read all of this. It gets kind of long. But there are many websites that relate to ham radio, some individual, some activities. Others are more involved and seek to entertain the viewer. Ham Nation and Amateur Logic come to mind. I think Amateur Logic wants to educate as well as entertain, but Mike says entertain. One site that deviates from the usual is Amateur Radio Now. Uh-oh, Mike, it's Ham Radio Now. You're pretty close. What makes the site stand out from the bunch is it doesn't follow the usual pattern or presentation model, and the videos are very professional, because I'm a pro. Most of the material is interviews. There are tons, over 130 and counting, ranging from interviews to individuals to capturing presentations at conferences. Favorites, HackRF, any of the TAPR stuff, my interview with Randy, K7AGE, APRS Mobile with a Raspberry Pi, which is one of the TAPR. The Village Telco is a talk from a couple of TAPRs ago that... VK6APH, I think is his call, the fellow that is currently working on Codec 2. And Village Telco is a project that they're doing in Africa, which is trying to not wire, because they're doing it wirelessly, but get telephone communications in very poor rural areas with sort of a mesh network. It's one of the earlier programs. Moving on. be forewarned, you may find that some of these videos are boring. You will discover very early, this is my favorite part, you will discover very early that they all are lengthy. However, you will not know whether they can expand your personal knowledge unless you take the time to wade through them. So that's great, Mike. I think you've got the idea. Last but not least, I got a phone call from my father-in-law, Mac W4PVT, yesterday. He's all excited. He said, do you want to work the King of Spain? Oh, well, cool. Because you might have seen this on our website. King Juan Carlos of Spain, EA0JC, is stepping down. His son, Prince Philippe, is going to take over. Not really familiar with the government of Spain. I think the monarchy there, kind of like England, is more a figurehead than a governmental, but maybe a little bit more governmental. Hard to say. Anyway, he's stepping down. He's been a ham. And Max said he was on 15 meters. So I swiftly went over to 15 meters to take a look, and I grabbed my cell phone and shot a little bit of video of it. And this is me making a DX contact.
Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec. Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec.
So I didn't hold out a lot of hope because the signal was pretty weak.
Kilowatt November 4, Alpha, Quebec.
And that call sign didn't sound quite right. It was a little bit hard to pick out.
Kilowatt November 4, Alpha, Quebec.
Just running 100 watts in a dipole.
Kilowatt November 4, Alpha, Quebec.
Never give up. Never give up. The signal's getting a little stronger. That noise level's from...
Kilowatt November 4, Alpha, Quebec.
There we go.
Kilowatt November 4, Alpha, Quebec. Roger, 5973.
Okay, so... The 59 I gave him was bogus because his signal clearly wasn't that strong. Everybody, you know, the 59 unfortunately has sort of become the default, you know, just something that you say. He was, if I was being honest, it was not that easy to copy. I did finally get the call sign, Echo Foxtrot 6, but I think I got that in playing back the video, not listening to him on the air. So he would have been a readability at best of 4, probably legitimately more like a 3, and a strength of about 3 or 4. I got a bit of a noise level. It comes from the computers and routers and the Ethernet switch and stuff that I got. Every one of those pieces that I turned off knocks, if I can turn them off, which I mostly can't, or the network goes down, adds an S unit or so, depending on what band I'm on, and it makes kind of a high noise level. Although it wasn't that bad there, but I guess 3 or S4. So in the legitimate signal report would have been more like a 3x4, but you never hear anybody give a report like that. And when you're talking to a DX station, he doesn't really care what his real signal report is. He wants to move on to the next contact. So again, Mac had said that it was King Juan Carlos, but King Juan Carlos's call sign is EA0JC. So who is Echo Alpha 6? Well, it turns out it's a special event station. I'm sorry, Echo Foxtrot 6. Turns out it's a special event station celebrating the proclamation of D. Felipe de Borbón as the new king of Spain, Felipe VI. So that was not the king. I looked at some DX spots afterwards, some leftover DX spots, and a lot of them were shortening down the special event thing to King of Spain, and that's probably what Max saw, so he thought he had worked the King of Spain, and so did I until I got ready to do this program and discovered that it was not the King of Spain. Too bad. But now that he's going to be out of office, he may have some more time to spend on the air. When you're an ex-king, what else are you going to do? Get on ham radio. So that's it for this episode of Ham Radio Now with a little embedded Kickstarter thing. The Kickstarter folks have not approved the campaign yet. I expect that they will, and I will put the video in there, edit it all up, put the titles on, get it in, and push the go button for the campaign a little bit later on today. It is Sunday. Ooh. I was trying to run a stopwatch. How foolish of me. June 22nd. Sunday, June 22nd. So sometime this week, a little bit before field day, the Kickstarter will probably become available. Speaking of field day, I'm not doing the same field day thing that I've done for many, many years now. Past a decade, practically, Jeff and I have been doing a go-to station at the Raleigh Amateur Radio Society field day. This year, we have a secret project. We are going to get on the road. And I'm not going to tell you what we're going to do until we've got it done. But we're going to be on the road for field day. You might hear us. Look for KN4AQ operating a 1 Charlie on whatever band we can make some contacts on. We'll be hunting and searching and pouncing. I don't think we're going to try to hold a run frequency from a 100-watt mobile, even as one as effective as mine. But I will shoot some video as we're going down the road. And one thing that has maybe surprised me is, as I'm going to and from our field day site during the contest hours, because I'm old and don't want to spend all night, I come home Saturday night and head back out early Sunday morning. And I get on the air. Can't work the station we were at, the W4DW, W4RNC station. You can't work the station that you've been participating in, but you can work anybody else. And I would just dial up and down the band. I'm not logging, so I have to be careful not to be a dupe for anybody. So I start at the bottom of a band, 40 meters, 20 meters, 15 if it's open, 10 if it's open, and just start working stations. And I'm surprised at how easy it is to make contacts. Sometimes you don't get through. But most of the time, one or two or three calls, and my pipsqueak mobile signal does get me through. So we'll be doing some of that as we are doing our secret project out there on the road. Arvin, his nose is a little bit out of joint because of the Kickstarter. He thinks he can fund the whole thing. But Arvin, no way. This has not worked as a put the videos up and ask for contributions. It would probably do better now. We're getting more and more well-known, and people are appreciating the projects more and more. But I think a Kickstarter is still what we need to do to really make sure that all the funding is in place for getting out to Austin and shooting the program. But if you're liking what you're seeing now, Kickstarter's not paying for that. So hamradionow.tv will put Arvin back to work and keep things going on this end. That's it. I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ. Thanks for watching 73. Over and out.